But we begin tonight with how we felt 13 weeks ago as we braced ourselves for a four-week lockdown. From 11:59 tonight, it will become a reality for more than 300,000 residents across 10 postcodes and 36 suburbs across Melbourne. It comes as cases there continue to rise, with 73 new cases reported today, and most of those are community transmission. Residents in lockdown will only be able to leave home to exercise or work, buy essential items, and to access child or health care. Anyone crossing the state border into New South Wales from the lockdown zones could be jailed for up to 6 months, and there's an $11,000 instant fine for breaching the rules. The decision to put parts of the city into lockdown has been seized upon on this side of the ditch, with the Prime Minister describing New Zealand as a safe haven in a dangerous world, but warning the Melbourne scenario could happen here. And in an extra twist, breaches by staff in Victoria's quarantine system are suspected to be the cause of the outbreak, as New Zealand works to plug gaps in its own border regime. Here's our political editor, Jane Patterson.
36 Melbourne suburbs will go back into lockdown in a matter of hours, to the dismay of residents and local businesses.
Pure shock and horror. It was just like being punched, really.
Movements around the affected suburbs will be restricted, and people will only be allowed to leave the house for food and essentials, work and study, caregiving or exercise until July the 29th. The situation facing restaurant owner Janine Barrican, who's now busy cancelling all future bookings, will bring back bad memories for those in New Zealand's hospitality scene.
We have bookings all the way till next month already, so when I got here, I had to call people and tell them that I have to cancel just because of the lockdown.
Each and every home within those postcodes from 11:59pm tomorrow night will have to stay in their homes. Except for those four.
The Victorian Premier, Daniel Andrews, outlining the conditions ahead of the lockdown at midnight Australian time. He said failures in the state's hotel quarantine program were a key factor in dozens of coronavirus cases.
Attributable via genomic sequencing to staff members in hotel quarantine breaching well-known and well-understood infection control protocols. That is unacceptable to me. I'm sure that will be unacceptable, certainly, to all of those who will be impacted by the restrictions.
Back in New Zealand, the Director General of Health, Ashley Bloomfield, said the news from Australia should serve as a reminder
that community transmission in the future is a real possibility, and we may here need to take measures to local measures to counteract community transmission if it occurs again. We will be watching carefully, continue to work on a daily basis with our Australian colleagues to see what's happening there.
Echoed by the Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern a short time later.
It is an example of how easily the virus can take hold again and why vigilance is so important. It is a good reminder that New Zealand is currently a safe haven in a very dangerous world.
Dr. Bloomfield making a plea on behalf of Air New Zealand crew who aren't always getting a friendly reception.
Some staff and crew members, particularly those flying international routes, have been facing some hostility and suspicion in their local communities. Again, this could be your friend or a family member.
There are still more than 360 people who left managed isolation after 2 weeks in early June, but who were not tested. They've been contacted repeatedly but have not come forward. Ms. Ardern has a personal message for them.
Do your bit. Get back in contact. It's a small thing that you can do as a member of our team of 5 million.
Nationals leader Todd Muller says the missing 367 people is another indictment of the system.
And we still have these many hundreds of people in the community that haven't been identified yet and haven't been tested, which from our perspective underlines how incompetent this has been for so many weeks.
Meanwhile, New Zealand has joined a global initiative, the COVAX facility, that aims to give all countries access to a vaccine if and when one is created. Details like how much money New Zealand will contribute are still being decided. From Parliament for Checkpoint, Jane Patterson.